Hello, this is Dr. Atterberg, and this is the last section in our mechatronic series dealing with systems. We will follow up the book of W. Bolton, and this is lecture over here, module 12. However, I chose to discuss a state-of-the-art mechatronic system which is embedded within a fun learning object, which is called Amazon Web Services DeepRacer. We'll take a look at its mechatronic components. We'll see what kind of smart sensor it is using. We'll see what application can be derived from this technology. Also, we'll talk about deep learning. We'll get started with Intel Convolution Neural Network FreeKids. And then the DeepRacer reinforced learning process. We'll take a look at how this has been done. And then also at the sample Python training code for the reinforcement program, which is used in the car. And then we'll see how we can get started with Amazon DeepRacer car. The mechatronic components, as we see over here, include a car, all the mechanical components, the body and the wheels and the shafts. And then it has an Intel microprocessor and has a memory of 4 gigabytes. And it's a random access memory, has 32 gigabytes expandable storage. Then he has a Wi-Fi communication. He has a smart camera using Intel with 4 megapixels. It's using software by Intel, OpenVINO. We'll take a look at this too. And then he has a power supply for the operation in a battery. And he has a computation battery. He has ports for communication. And also it has sensors which include an accelerometer and a gyroscope. The mechatronics that we'll be using, vision, machine learning, will actually set the road for innovation. This is an Intel promotional video which I'll refer to. And what you see here that it is based on a convolutional neural network called CNN. Now, CNN is a kind of a frightening word for folks who are not data scientists. And I suggest I'm not a CNN expert, nor do I intend to be one. But when I got into a term like this, I dip into it and try to understand what it is. So if we have a picture that we want to compare a camera image and decide whether it's a dog or a cat or a boat or a traffic light, then what we do, we take we divide the image to many pixels. We take the picture a characteristic identification with zero and ones. Then what we do is we see, we overlap it over the image and see how much do we score in making this similar to the camera image. So on this nine block, northwest, we got 4. And then over here, we got 3, 4. And right now, we're in the south section. And what you see here is that the image has 011, 011, 110. This is what it's in here. And we're comparing it to what the picture says, 101, 010, 101. And then we see where we score. So when we embed this one and this, we don't see a score here, 1 and 0, 1 and 0, where we get a hit here. And then we look at this one and we get a hit, and then we get a hit. But then all the other ones don't get hit. So we end up with a score of 3. And then we could see that if we'll get another 4 over here, it will increase the probability that we will select that particular image that has that we have all 4 on the diagonal, and we'll have 4 on one end So this is going to be often we have to estimate that there's a possibility. The applications that we see over here using CNN in autonomous vehicles, it's embedded in the vehicle and it can define cars as we see over here, and it can define signs and also persons over here. The features of a smart sensor that can be obtained from OpenVINO toolkit, pretty much free of charge from Intel, will teach us principles of computer vision, deep learning inference, and artificial intelligence applications. So it's an excellent way to get started learning this at your free time. The applications are enormous. It could be in surveillance, retail, manufacturing, smart cities, healthcare, office automation, and transportation. The modeling is an important part of it, as we see that Intel has a pre-trained model to make our life a little easier. So that's important. And then the software is also part of the kit. And you see that the deep learning workload was lastly tested by Intel a year ago. So this, we're talking state-of-the-art technology. And since they have an edge with the technology, you see that this is only applicable to Intel microprocessors. In the future, as competition will increase, it may be an open source. Now, getting started with a free tool, you click on the icon that we have over here, and it'll lead you to get started with webinars, how to do it, and more help sessions. Now, getting started with Amazon machine learning tutorials, and particularly with reinforcement learning that is being used in this particular mechatronic device, the race car, we see that the processes to learn the reinforced learning model, okay, create it, train it, and then evaluate it, and then clone the model, and then when you're happy with the results, you may join the deep racing league. Now, the getting started with Amazon Deep Racer is a simple process. You click on this icon, and it takes you step by step creating an account, and then setting you up in getting started with training your virtual model. Now, what is reinforcement learning? It has over here the elements. You have an engine that has to take action. This is autonomous action. There's no person or human intervention with the decision to take an action. High-level intelligence. Now, the action is interacting with the environment, and then there is a result. The result is the state of the agent after the action was taken. Now, the software that we write in order to lead the agent to reach its objective is so-called the reward. And that's the part of our programming effort. Now, in our particular case, the reinforcement actions that the agent can take is steering wheel and throttle. And it could change the direction of motion and increase or decrease the throttle to maintain the best action that will lead to the best reward. Now, you see over here that the reinforcement training is done as an iterative process. Every training, for example, the car started here. The car did not know that this is the best route to the finish line. So it started going over here and got stuck over here with the border. So then, and you get the total reward was low. Then the car learned that it cannot go over here, so it take another angle that over here, and it find out that it's stuck over here. And then it takes another angle and find out that it stuck over here. So you see, that's like a zigzagging operation of learning through iterative episode, which finally try to maximize the objective function. The final result, after we train the car and the car has enough times to integrate, of course they limit the number of times that you could train, and also the number of times, but when you're done to perfection, then the car figured out that the best reward is if it goes straight ahead, where each step provides him a score of 2, any other place is a score of a reward of 0.2. Now, the parameters that we can use in order to define the reward are shown over here. We have a position of the car, the XY within the universal coordinate system. We have the heading of the car, what angle the car is heading in this global coordinate system. We have waypoints. We have over here 30 waypoints, which are grouped along the truck. We have over here a width of the truck as a parameter. We have over here a distance of the car from the center line. We may give it a high reward if the distance, for example, is low, and a low reward if the distance is high. Here's a on-off, false true for a parameter that says is all the wheels on the truck. We see that over here it's not, so it's false. And over here the speed is a parameter, and the steering angle is another parameter. Now the reward function is shown over here, programmed in Python. It shows, for example, a reward to stay on the truck. High reward if there's no wheels off the truck. And what we see over here that we define a function, reward function, bring in the Python parameters that were defined as I explained before. And then we read the parameters, the input parameters. We define a variable always on the truck, its parameters always on the truck. Distance from the center, whatever we bring in here, we redefine that as a variable to work with it. Then we may give it a reward, very low, as a default. And then we check if all the wheels on the truck, and this is this condition, which is coming in from the function. Then we will give it the end also, not only that, but also that 0.5 the truck minus the distance from the truck. In other words, that we are greater than zero, meaning that we are within the truck, no overshoot, then we'll give it a reward 1. And then we return with the reward value. Here's an example. If we give a reward, if the car is close to the center. So again, we read the parameters, and truck width is in the parameter here, and we bring it in. Distance from the center is a parameter. We bring in it here for the software. Then we define some marker. Marker 1 is 0.1 times the truck width, marker 2, marker 3. And then we say that the reward is being done with the if function. If the distance from the center is less than marker 1, okay, so it's 0.1, very close to the center, then we give it high reward, and then if it's further out, lower and lower, and then else if it crashes, we give it a zero reward. Over here, we see that one policy could be don't limit the car to make its own decision, because before we limit it to certain parameters. Over here, the car is free to evaluate all parameters, and there is no incentive that we give the car on its parameters. So the return is 1 for any decision that the car is doing. The Competition of deep pressure is done worldwide and also with a real racer, and many people are coming from different locations for that test. It's a big event, and also in a simulated version. To get started with the deep racer, I recommend, and this is also a very nice, fun to learn process. You click on this icon, and it gets you to this page, and you can see what is the, this pretty much the documentation, what is Amazon services, web services. How does it work? How do we get started? How do we set up an account? It goes you through all these processes. And then in addition, it gets you started with the simulated car race. This completes our presentation, and we'll do more in a laboratory, some racing, and have fun with it. Thank you.